we use algorithms really to solve a problem. And now we've moved into the area of artificial intelligence, we really are looking at how we can solve problems. So one example is to use a heuristic. In this video, we're going to look at the Manhattan distance as a heuristic to help solve the 8 puzzle. Well, we've got tiles and we want to put them in order. We start off with this simple board where the numbers are not in order. And our goal is this board where the numbers are in order. We have a blank or 0 and 1 to 8. Now, the score that we're going to use is created from the Manhattan distance from the move up and down or left and right to the goal for each tile. So what does that mean? Let's look at the moves. Here we can see the blank tile or the space. We could move the 4 tile down into that space. Alternatively, we could move the 7 tile there. So we've got 2 options. Now we need to work out the distance to the goal. What does this mean? Well, here we can see that the 4 tile needs to move 1 place to the left to reach its goal. Here we've got 1 in the left bottom corner and its goal is the middle at the top. So as far as moves go, we know we have to move 1 to the right at some point. We also have to move 2 up. 7 here is at the goal position, so it doesn't need to move. So we know how we can move the tile from its current position to its goal. So if we do that with all of the tiles and work out a score, the blank tile we're going to call 0 because we still got to put it in the correct position, if you like. So you could use that or you could omit that. It's up to you. But the heuristic that we're going to use here, we're going to look at each tile, each position, and say how many moves would be needed to make minimum to reach the goal position. And then we're going to add them up. So we can see the benefits of some moves. So for example, here we have a space to the right in the middle. And if we move tile 2 to that space, we can see at first we have a total of 22. But when we move it, we have a total of 20. So you can see the scores have pretty much stayed the same except for the actual 2 tile and the tile where there is a space. And you can see that the amount of moves to the goal has been reduced by 2. You can see we could also move the number 3 there, and that would also remove 2 off the total. And if we move 4 there, then the total would be the same. So we could either move the number 2 tile or the number 3 tile and reduce the total. Here's another example. We could move the 4 down to the space. We have a total, or 7. We have the same total. So sometimes the moves don't increase or decrease the score. When we move, we want to make the lowest total, and also we don't want to move back from the moves we've previously done. So we don't reverse the last move, and we attempt not to go to the same position we've been before. So we choose the lowest. If it's equal, then we have a random selection, but we don't want to repeat the previous position. Otherwise, we could just have 3 tiles that are just changing place in an infinite circle, and then that would break our algorithm, our program. So in summary, the Manhattan distance we use to calculate the lowest total to the goal, the scores are based on the position of each tile, and that is how many moves there are to the goal, either going up or down or left and right. Let's have a look at some of the Python code now. To start off, we need to create this function that finds the position of the tile in our goal state. How are we going to finish? So if we look here, we're going to start at the top left of our board. So the top left is position 0. That's where the space is going to go. Now if we move 1 along, that's where the number 1's going to be. And 2 along isn't where the number 2's going to be. So the top row is going to be have a 0, 1 or 2, or have the space, the tile with the 1 and the tile with the 2. Then the middle tiles will be 3, 4 and 5. So they're 1 down, 0 along, 1 along, 2 along. And finally the bottom we have tiles with 6, 7 and 8. And they're going to be 2 down and 0, 1 and 2 along. So we can work out for the position from the top left corner. So what we're doing here is we're saying where's the position of the tile going to be when we complete our task, when we have the solution. So we need to do that, and we can do that in the Python code with a simple if, elif statement and a for loop here just to show you the example. Now our starting board has at the top 563, in the middle 820 or space, and bottom 174. So we put a 0 there because we need to have something in our arrays to say where the space is. And our board is going to be a two-dimensional array, or list, two-dimensional list in Python, we should say. So when we look at our tile, we can see each one by using the list of the position. So for example, the first number is 5, so when we run that, we can print it, we can see 5. And if we looked at the bottom, would be 2, 2, we should get the value 4, because that's at the bottom. Okay, so if we had 0, 2, what number do you think we should see? 3. So that's the top, 0, that's the first list, and position 2, the number 3. Okay, so if you thought it was 1, that's actually 2 down and 0 across, if we wanted to see the 1. There we go. Okay, so that's now our starting board. We could see all of them if we, for example, created for loops. So now we can look at each tile. So when we go through the top, 563, then the middle, 820, bottom 174. So these are positions from the top left to the bottom right. So we have our starting board. Now we want to have our goal. So the board, what's the board going to be like when we finish? So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that's the same data structure, two-dimensional list. And how are we going to create the Manhattan distance? Well, we're going to look at each tile. So we can create in a loop. So we go from top row, middle, then bottom, and also from left to center to right. And we go for each tile. Now each tile, we're going to get the value. We're going to get where it's supposed to be. So position where it is, position where it needs to be. And then we can work out the value of going up or down or left and right. Now, if we travel left or up, it's going to be a minus number. So we change the minus number to positive using function ABS. And then when we do that, for each tile, which in here is the value estimate, we're going to add that to the final distance. So we do that, we can run it, and we have a score of 22. Okay, just for completeness, we can see we have another example. Let's move this. And where we've got our starting board, let's create our new example 2. And take out our previous one. And now let's run the code and then check to see if it's correct. So here we've got 724506831, and if we run that, we have a score of 20. Now let's check to see if that's correct. So here's our board for the second example, 724506831. Now the goal positions, we can put them here in red, And you can see if we move, for example, 7, go 1 across, 2 down, that's going to be 3 moves. We do that for each tile. You can see in green here. And then if we add them up, we get a total of 20. So our code is correct. So we can use the Manhattan distance to calculate the distance to our goal as a heuristic, and then use that heuristic in artificial intelligence to find the solution to our problem. Now, how efficient that is, how quick it is, does it always work, etc., is part of working out how good our algorithms are to solve a problem in artificial intelligence. So that's part of the research. If you're interested in more algorithms or more artificial intelligence, heuristics, or even solving the 8 puzzle completely, let us know in a comment. If you like that video, please give us a like, and if you haven't already, please subscribe.